Is that our juggernaut out doing this shit while you standing there?
We do not have a vetting process in place. That's according to the CIA and the FBI.
I got killed.
So the question begs is, what vetting
process? Yo, why they get killed like in 2 damn hits, but it takes forever for them, they shit to get killed.
Into our middle-income communities because these refugees are not being resettled in the affluent communities or in the politicians' neighborhoods.
You go left, I'm going to go right this time.
While
you're standing there.
That makes it okay to move these people into the neighborhoods of the United States. And I do think that's a question for the national spokesperson. But since I have you here, I want to know what the vetting process would be for Donald Trump. You're talking about the CIA and the FBI, institutions that clearly Donald Trump does not agree with how they're vetting right now. You're saying he should get together with Congress. It is controlled by his party at this point in time.
Well, there is. So what are his ideas about?
Oh, damn, they got my ass.
There is no disagreement with the intelligence agencies on the vetting process.
Like it's three on right.
But there isn't a vetting process, and that is the problem.
The juggernaut is going forward on right.
You have the FBI director and the CIA saying that there isn't. So Mr. Trump wants to stop people from coming into this country that cannot be verified or vetted until we can get a process in place.
My finger's about to die.
From the intelligence.
I don't know, they juggernaut about to die.
Because if I did, I would be happy to create a vetting process for you. But unfortunately, all lawmakers right now have not done that. That's exactly what they're working on.
Well, let me describe to you, actually, there is a vetting process in place. And this is what it is. The vetting begins with the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, which determines who will count as a refugee, who should be resettled, that's about 1%. And then which countries should take them. This alone can take quite some time, 4 to 10 months. Their names, their biographical information, their fingerprints, they're run through federal terrorism and criminal databases. And then the refugees are interviewed by the Homeland Security Department. Then if they're approved, they undergo a medical screening, a match with sponsor agencies that hold cultural orientation classes, and one final security clearance. That's a process that can take 1 to 2 years, even longer, and happens before a refugee ever steps onto American soil. How does Donald Trump want, and this is according to PolitiFact, this vetting process and the concept of it has been vetted itself. How does Donald Trump want to change that? You're saying there's no vetting process. I just read the vetting process. How does he want to change
it? Right. Now, look, here's the thing. We're not going to base national security on PolitiFact or even the United Nations. We're going to listen to our intelligence agencies, like the CIA and the FBI, who said those are worthless because many of these people don't show up in these systems simply because they are not on anyone's record. There is no way to vet these people right now, and that's the problem. Just because there's some arbitrary system in place at the United Nations, that
I described one that has the ability to find out
who these people all are coming.
In fairness, Katrina, the process I described involves federal U.S. agencies. It may start at the U.N., but there are agencies, several of them in the U.S., including the Homeland Security Department, that is involved.
Absolutely, which is exactly why the CIA and the FBI says these systems do not work. We cannot vet these people. It is entirely impossible to vet these people right now because they're not in any of these systems, and that's the problem.
All right, Katrina Pearson, thank you so much for joining us. We certainly appreciate it.
No, he's killing shit. He got to stay here now. And protect since they say, okay. They're going to like, okay, you ain't doing nothing. See ya.
And the National Guard deployed to West Virginia for an urgent door-to-door search in the flood disaster zone.
He's just trying to find out which way do we go.
I ended up picking Weasley to build my weapon.
Because they keep coming from right and left, and we gotta stay here now. If we can kill all of them at the same time, instead of getting two and two, we can push on your side. Oh, this dude chased me down.
The equivalent of 30 jumbo jets filled.
50 folks. Now I'm almost down for a whole minute. Are you serious? Why didn't things say I only got one kill? Lucky got 18 over there.
Shit.
I'm dead. Can you do your backflip?
We do our part to help. Please, go online, call this number, and join the U.S. Fund for NASA today. With your monthly gift of $15, just 50 cents a day, you'll provide life-saving nutrition, urgently needed medical care, and vaccines. UNICEF will deliver these things on your behalf, right to the children. Please join today. Visit this website or call now with your $15 monthly donation for the children. It's a simple, life-saving action. And only 50 cents a day give these children what they need to survive. And when you give to others who need our help, life is truly out of touch. I hope you'll join me in doing whatever it takes to make sure no child dies needless. Please go online or call with your monthly gifts today.
Talking to me? Yeah, I have. Thor is on the left side real quick, Clint. I had to kill the Juggernaut.
Controversial proposal to ban Muslim immigrants from entering the U.S. This, as Trump fires back at new attacks from both Hillary Clinton and Senator Elizabeth Warren. Let's bring in our panel now. Rebecca Berg, she is the national political reporter for Real Clear Politics. We have CNN political director David Chalian, CNN chief political analyst Gloria Borger, and CNN senior legal analyst Jeffrey Toobin. I want to start with you, Gloria, because this is actually your...
Damn it, man. This dude fast, that fast down.
Expecting Donald Trump.
Oh, my God. He started speeding up and down. The arrows won't stop, dog.
So now not emphasizing that...
He got you.
Label,
yeah.
...also deter what Katrina Pierce is a national spokeswoman said about this. What do you think?
Well, Jim Acosta and I are reporting that there is definitely a softening of this temporary ban on Muslims that is no longer focused on Muslims. What it now says is that there would be a temporary ban on people coming from countries who train and equip terrorists. To me, that shows this kind of change in tenor, but it also...
Damn. Oh my God. That Loki, I mean, that Cupid dude, man.
Would it apply to a country like Saudi Arabia, for example, who is an ally of ours?
And won't take too kindly, perhaps, right? Then, right?
Exactly. And this is a
European
deal. Right. And this is still in the works. It is being finalized. They have not announced it yet, but we should expect Donald Trump to be talking about it in the
and
belt. Good feeling. B5 and what?
I programmed them to feel burning.
And so I think you're seeing here a candidate who is starting to try to put the building blocks together to have a
candidate. Juggernaut's about dead. He's dead.
But it's late already in the process. But actually,
God killed bonus.
There are only like three
fatality. Got a trophy.
Trump is known for. He's going to build a wall. Mexico's going to pay for it. And he's going to not allow Muslims into the United States. How do you back away from the only proposal for the
campaign? I think, remember, when you talk about Will Hughes, also talk about that there would be a big deal with the world. I just thought his emphasis was going to change as soon as he wrapped up the nomination. And so it is surprising to me that he has done this in baby steps and taking some other time instead of just aggressively repositioning.
But I think,
and I agree with you, it's difficult. All the things you take there is to push back on it, right. But who can campaign with it?
So I think they've been trying to get him to do that, particularly somebody like Paul Ryan. But I think he got in his own way. Because, don't forget, he was talking about Judge Curiel. He had those problems he had to deal with. And so maybe he was trying to shift course, but then he had to course correct in the middle of the shifting. And I think it gets a little complicated. And I think now, as they head into the convention, the timing is very clear. They want to get everyone on the same page. They don't want to give Paul Ryan, the Speaker of the House, an opportunity to yet again back away from Donald Trump. So they're trying to corral everyone, and this is one way to try and do it.
Is this something that can bring Republicans, establishment Republicans, on board? Is this the way?
What's that one we ain't played yet?
I would kind of look at this in the opposite way, that this is
you about to leave?
major concern that most Republicans have had. Even who have endorsed Donald Trump, that has been making their life very difficult. And so this isn't necessarily something that Republicans who have been holding out on endorsing Donald Trump are going to say, oh, well, now everything's great and we're going to support him. But I think the Republicans who have already even endorsed him and have had these lingering concerns, this is going to help. There's been a lot of pressure from Republican leaders. You've mentioned Mitch McConnell and Paul Ryan, who have spoken out publicly against a Muslim ban, as Donald Trump proposed it originally. And so this has been very great public pressure, and this will help at least with a facade of party unity going into the convention in that regard.
They were saying the ban was unconstitutional, because you can't ban people because of their religion, because it is.
It is. Exactly. Thank you.